Let's continue with our last topic. We are supposed to do prefix and postfix operators. Now, prefix increment operators. We already know that increment operators add one number in the already value. Whatever value is already there in the variable, it add one value in that. Now, prefix increment operator, x is equal to x plus 1. This is increment. And x is equal to x minus 1. This is decrement operator. We already discussed in our last lecture. Now, both of these operators, they can be prefix and they can be postfix. Now, let's take the example of prefix increment operator. First of all, p is equal to 5. P is equal to plus plus p multiplied by 4. Now, here p is increased by 1 and then multiplied by 4. Now, the p will be increased by 1. P's value will be 6. Now, here p is equal to 6 multiplied by 4. And the final value of the p is 24. So here the value is increased before it gets multiplied. Now, next is prefix decrement. Here again, the value will be decreased by 1 and then multiplied. Since it is the prefix, first of all, will decrease the value or increase the value. Now, p is equal to minus minus p multiplied by 5. Here, the value, if the value already is 5, minus minus p will be 4 and then it will be multiplied by 5, it will be 20. So, my dear friends, the comparison we need to check that prefix operator is this. When the variable has been prefixed by this operator, increment operator. Now, this variable has been prefixed by decrement operator. Now, one more time, let me tell you again that prefix, the value will be increased by 1 because this is the increment operator. Increment operator, we discussed in our last chapter, last lecture, that it will be increasing the value by 1. Now, p increased by 1, then multiplied by 4. And the final value will be 24. Then here minus minus p multiplied by 5. Here the p's value will be, first of all, decreased by 1 and then multiplied by 5. So, hence it will be 4 because earlier it was 5, and then multiplied by 5, it will make p, the value of p, 20. Now, let's cover the next topic, which is the postfix increment and postfix decrement. As the name suggests, postfix means afterwards, means suffix also we can tell. Now, postfix, we can write p plus plus, not plus plus p. The difference between prefix is plus plus p and postfix is p plus plus. Now, my dear friends, p's value here is 5. P is equal to p plus plus multiplied by 4. Now, p is not incremented by 1 before it gets multiplied. P will be the same. Its value will be 5, then multiplied by 4, and it will make it p's value 20. And later on, it will add 1 in the p's value. Now, similarly, postfix decrement. P is equal to 5. Suppose the variable p has the value 5 stored in that memory location, and then p is equal to p minus minus multiplied by 5, semicolon. Now, p's value will be 5 only. It will not be 4. It will not deduct one number from its value. Why? Because it is postfix decrement. Later on, it will deduct one value from the total answer, whatever answer will be there. Now, p minus minus multiplied by 5 means p earlier value will be 5. It's not deducting number 1. It is taking 5 and then multiplied by 5, it will be 25. And later on, my dear friends, it will deduct one number from that whole value, whatever value is there. Let's take now these. Till now we have covered unary arithmetic operator. Unary, let's revise what were the unary and what were the binary arithmetic operators. Unary, where we have one operand. Here we have only one operand, here this P. So, and the binary arithmetic operator, where we have two operands. Now, for example, it deals with two operands, as we already know. Now, A is equal to 22, B is equal to 5, semicolon. Here, A plus B will be 27. Now, my dear friends, this is binary arithmetic operator. Next is A minus B, it will be 17, because 22 minus 5 will be 17. Then A multiplied by B will be 110, as A is 22, B is 5. And A divided by B is equal to 4, as A is 22 and B 5. And we already know that A divided by B, here 22 divided by 4, 5s are 20, and its answer will be B is 5. B is 5, answer will be 4. So the quotient will be 4. And last is modulus operator A modulus B, the answer will be 2. Here remainder. Modulus operator will always be giving you remainder. So this was all about operators. So I hope you understand. Thank you. Bye-bye.